YouTubers, what's up everyone? Jordan here, and today we have the very first episode of Game Time Reviews, and the lucky winner for today's show is the Philips CDI. Take it all in, everybody. Take it all in. That is one nice looking machine, and let me tell you, I've seen a lot over my years, so I got really lucky. I mean, I found this console and about 60 games at a tag sale. I paid $50. $50, man. Go on eBay right now. Check that out for yourself. You will literally shit your pants. I mean, this thing is expensive. So, lucky me, right? I hope all of you guys can get deals like this too. You know, you just gotta keep looking, you know? They're out there. You just gotta keep on going. So, this is the revised model. Okay, this is the 550. Let me tell you a little bit, though, about how it all started. The CDI, when it originally came out, it debuted in December of 1991, okay, and it was $800. Yeah, 800, crazy. And it kind of looked like a DVD player, and it actually, the remote control was, it looked like a TV remote. I don't know what Philips was thinking, how you were going to play games with that. I have no idea. So that was $800, and then if you wanted to play movies and a lot of the music and video games, you needed to shell out an additional $400 for this digital video cartridge. I mean, you're looking at $1,200. That was some investment back in 91. So that's why many people didn't buy it. You could go out and buy a Super Nintendo for, you know, $200 back then. So why not? The one thing the CDI had over the Super Nintendo and the Genesis at that time was technical specs. This thing was pretty beastly. It had a 15 megahertz processor, okay? It could do 16 million colors, had a megabyte of RAM. That's really good stuff for 91. So that has something to do with the price. But it didn't catch on. Philips didn't know how to advertise it. They didn't know if it was for, you know, education purposes or games. They kind of wanted it to do everything. So they didn't know where to market it. So they realized they were losing, and they were losing fast. So in 1994, they released the 450 and the 550 console. They totally revised it. They made it look like a game console instead of a DVD player. It looks much better. Much, much better in my opinion. The only difference between the 450 and the 550 is they look exactly the same, but the 550 came with the digital video cartridge pre-installed, and some of the later boxes also included this sweet-ass controller. Now, let me tell you about this controller. This is how you play the CDI. I wouldn't play it any other way. The other controllers are pure crap. They actually have a Gravis controller, which is pretty good, but this takes the cake right here. This controller, it's kind of like a Dreamcast and a Genesis all in one. Okay, if that makes sense to you. The back has these really nice grips. Okay, it really fits your hand nicely. And the front feels like a Genesis. The D-pad's nice. Everything is nice, you know? Really, really good quality. That's the way to play the CDI. When this came out, by the way, this was only $300. So they reduced it drastically. I mean, from $1,200 down to $300, they were really trying to it was either make it or break it, you know? So let me show you the console a little bit. This is your controller port. Don't ask me how you play two-player games. There must be some kind of adapter, I would imagine. On the side here, you have the on-off switch. Okay, very cool. You know, they kept the machine very sleek. They really did. I mean, you could just tell it's got no buttons anywhere. Okay, so let me show you the back. It's got the composite. And over here you have the AC adapter. So really nice, really nice stuff. Let me show you some gameplay, guys. All right, I know that's what you've been waiting for. Let's check it out. Alright, so for my next demonstration, I'm going to be showing you some choice software here. First up, we're going to have RoboCop, the movie. Alright, and then after that, I'm going to be showing you a little James Brown, Nonstop Hit Machine. Alright, I think we'll like that. And lastly, a little Space Ace, because I got to show you some game footage. But first, I want everyone to check this out. This was called See It, Hear It, Feel It, Woodstock 94. And what this was a demonstration video for Philips to try to sell this to companies. And you gotta see this. Let's fire it up. Here we go. So this is what Philips used to try to sell this thing. It's pretty far out there. And I have my camera on an angle to decrease the amount of black bars on the television. So for any of you guys out there trying to do the same thing, point your camera at an angle. Look at this guy.
We are all interested in the future. For that is where you and I will spend the rest of our lives.
It's fucking weird, man.
You are here because you are interested in the unknown, the mysterious, the unexplainable. That's why you're here. You have traveled great distance.
What were they thinking with this guy? Like, this is really gonna sell consoles? Alright, let me pop in some RoboCop.
It's really terrifying. And now, for the first time, we are bringing you the full report of what lies ahead. We cannot keep this a secret any longer.
All right. Enjoy this while I get RoboCop together. All right, that's enough of that. Let's pop in RoboCop. Now I have this hooked up via composite, so it's not going to be the best, but my TV's pretty good. Kind of sounds like VHS. The format is actually called VCD, which stands for Video CD, and it's been around for a long time. It never really took off in America, more so in places like China. But VCD probably falls somewhere between VHS and Laserdisc. God, what a great movie, man. This came out in 1987, I believe. I think I was about 4 years old back then.
You give us 3 minutes, and we'll give you the world.
Good morning. I'm Casey Wong with Jet Perfect. Top story, Pretoria. The threat of nuclear confrontation in South Africa.
So, okay. Definitely doesn't look fantastic. Looks like VHS, like clean VHS. Maybe SVHS?
Last line of defense.
Alright.
And the president's first press.
Let's check out some James Brown.
Peace platform.
Hit me.
A shaky start.
Alright. See what James Brown on CDI is all about. Okay.
Thing. I want to get into it, man, you know, like a sex machine, man.
Yeah.
Doing, doing it, you know. Can I count it off?
Go ahead.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Get up, get up now.
Stay on the scene. Get on up. I like a sex machine.
Okay.
Get up.
So it looks like it has a nice list of songs.
Get on up. I like a sex machine.
You can control it down here at the bottom. Rewind, fast forward, stop, play, pause. You can move the cursor around. You can select your song. Let's do Super Bad.
Watch me! Watch me!
It's so good.
I got it. Watch me!
Lickin' stick.
I got it.
Yeah. Naughty.
I got something that makes me wanna shout. I got something that tells me what it's all about.
See how many songs. Alright, we got 13 songs. You can even get the lyrics. Look at that, dude. That's pretty cool. Tells me what to do. So, you could have some karaoke over here. Let's check out more on JB up here. Let's see. 24-hour nonstop hit machine? Huh. And finally, I'm going to be showing you some footage of the game Space Ace. This game is incredible for its time.
Space Ace, defender of...
It's kind of like an interactive cartoon.
Ace is being attacked by the evil Commander Orf.
You couldn't do this on Super Nintendo. And I'm pretty sure they didn't try it on Sega CD because it just would have looked terrible.
By the Infanto Ray.
Struggle with Dexter to regain his manhood.
Remember, this was 1991. This was pretty early.
Defeat the evil Borf.
Hey, Borf. Come on, Kimberly, let's go.
Let's check it out.
There's Borf's ship.
It's going to throw me right into the action, isn't it? Oh, I died. Holy shit, that was quick.
There's Borf's ship.
I gotta move. Yeah. Oh, what? Wow. That is not easy, guys.
There's Borf's ship.
Right. Right. Oh, I got farther than I ever have. Nice. Oh. Okay. This is really fun. I mean, this is good. Yes, you're clicking left and right. A cell phone could do this. Wow. It doesn't get any easier, guys. But this is really great. This is really great. And, well, that's it for the CDI review. I really hope you liked it. As you can see, it really did a lot of great things. It didn't do anything really, really well, but it could do a lot, okay? Back in the day, they were really trying to sell this whole idea of multimedia. Everything on CD, you know, movies, videos, music, video games. It really could do it all. Unfortunately, it just didn't have the developers like Nintendo or Sega to create any great software for. So that's why you really don't hear about it today much. But listen, guys, thank you for watching, and stay tuned. The next game you're going to see is I'm doing a little review on a game called Burn Cycle, which I believe is one of CDI's best games, and maybe a couple after that. So please stay tuned. I hope you enjoyed, and take care, everyone.